Yeah, it's a good idea.
He's the fellow. I used to live a lot by the sea, and I remember once going out, saying I was going to go fishing with a cousin of my own age. And what we did was we went down to the fisherman, and for about sixpence, we got about a dozen mackerel. And we brought them back with great pride and lied and said, look what we've caught at the end of the pier. Down in the meadow in the little fishy pool, swam three little fishes and mama fish too. Swim, said the mama fishy, swim if you can. Swam and he swam right over the dam. Hey, I think I've caught one.
Jennifer, look, I can see something down there. Well done! Nice little trout, look.
Dear St. Peter, thank you.
Yes, there you are. God.
You may have the pleasure of taking the hook out.
Well, thank you. At least we have something to cook on the lure now.
And we must get some more. We have time.
Oh, yes. Anyway, St. Peter's doing you proud, so who knows? You may bring back a whole fleet.
A whole shoal of fishes.
That's right. The net was too heavy for them to carry it.
Lovely thought.
To you. I don't like dark brown onion soup, but that's just me. Well, that's very good. I'm glad for you. Well, you're not getting it today. And
now we start the egg bit. Throw that on the ground as we have ground.
Ah, well, you look very splendid in that outfit. Very Parisian chic, your headdress.
I'm trying to cover myself from head to toe because of these terrible midges. This is my helmet bag.
No.
My helmet bag. I hate this camping. I don't understand what you see in it.
Well, it goes back a long way. My grandmother lived in a tent in her drawing room in Little Venice.
How very sensible of her to put it in a drawing room.
Yeah, she was Irish and very eccentric. It was after my grandfather died. She was never quite the same again. Well, I think one should abandon the midges and retire.
All right, then. Better's for dits.
Quite so. I will light you to your slumbers.
Sweet Titania.
Right, well, sleep well.
Thank you very much, dear.
Not at all.
Let's return to a town soon.
Look at those donkeys. Awfully randy creatures, donkeys.
Oh, they're sweet. They took a great part in the Bible.
True.
I'm very fond of them.
Yes, well.
Not to be mocked.
No, indeed. Perish the thought, Jennifer.
Think what happened on Palm Sunday.
They have this extraordinary thing in Scotland. They don't sell loin of pork with the crackling. So you have to order it ages in advance.
I know, and they do it in France. They never have crackling. Maybe Mary Queen of Scots started it when she came over with her nasty French ways.
It's very possible.
I don't know anyone in England who doesn't like crackling, except those poor unfortunate vegetarians, I suppose. Heavens, what are you doing?
Supermarket!
Melody,
how are you?
Hello.
Very well, how are you?
Oh, nice to see you.
We've
come to have one of your delicious bacon sandwiches.
Right, okay. Two?
Yes, one each, right. And a cup of tea and a cup of Vauvreau, please.
Right.
Why are your bacon sandwiches so much better than everyone else's?
Well, we use local bacon, and my chef, actually, he goes and selects it.
And you taste it?
No, I don't. I have to confess, I'm a vegetarian, so I don't actually eat it.
How can you be? How can you stand the wonderful smell?
I just about do.
So good.
Well, you're doing a great service for those of us who aren't.
Ah, jolly good. There we go.
Wonderful. Truly unselfish. I'm told that more vegetarians relapse on bacon than any other substance.
It's the smell of it cooking, I would think. Mm. It is one of the best smells, isn't it?
Irresistible.
Bacon frying. Mm. It's absolutely lovely.
Great hangover cure in the days when I had hangovers.
Well, they always say that if you can manage it for a hangover, eat a full, hearty English breakfast instead of all these sort of fizzy things.
Right, a bit of fat.
The liver embraces it.
I suppose we should be on our way, really.
Off we go in servile bodies.
To the rally.
To the rally indeed. But you can't always find blood oranges, that's the trouble.
No, you get more of them nowadays.
Yeah. Of course, they don't call them blood orange anymore. It's ruby.
Is it?
Yes.
Oh, no.
No blood can be mentioned.
You like lunch, don't you, Jennifer?
Yeah, I like the idea of lunch, especially going out to lunch. I feel it's slightly naughty and immoral. You know, going to a really good restaurant and then to make it even worse, to go to a cinema afterwards, especially if the sun is shining.
I wish I had such an easier sense of wickedness.
It's just that you feel you should be at work, and there you are, having a lovely lunch.
So are you a lady who lunches?
I'm often out to lunch.
Yes, there's this sort of whole subculture, isn't there, of terribly thin, elegant women who go out to lunch.
Yeah, they're the sort, they go to sort of those restaurants where they go to be seen.
Well, this would be a good dish for them. I mean, it's terribly slimming.
Oh, my dear, far too much for ladies who lunch. They come in their Chanel or Givenchy clothes and order some sort of huge plate of salad, which they pick at, and then nothing else.
It is that ruddy Wallis Simpson's fault, you know. You've never been too rich or too thin. Look what happened to her.
Poor dear. Why don't we change places and dance with me?
Oh. Rather unusually, I'm cooking this on the top.
The stuff that was in the tomatoes, you can sieve and whiz and then make yourself a nice Bloody Mary to keep your spirits up. Well, in the East, I believe the sultans chose their ladies for their harem by how many cloves they could put into their navel.
Oh, well, I'd have been first on the list,
they
I
liked
guess,
eh? They liked a large navel.
I'd rather have a diamond.
Well, if you were a good harem girl, you'd probably get a diamond. Several.
Two, and look at that, done to perfection.
Orange, yes, perfect, perfect. Now what?
Well, one eats it.
Just take it in now.
Take it in, no? Yes, absolutely. Well, that was a bit of a change from ladies who lunch, wasn't it?
It was marvellous, but they have wonderful hats, nevertheless. Munch on, munch on. What a lovely lunch on.
It was a triumph.
It was several triumphs.
I can't quite still, though, understand this whole sort of motorcycle thing.
Why not? It's big boys Meccano. I mean, they know every nut and bolt. They love and treasure their animals and treat them with the greatest care and respect.
Anyway, chin chin.
And your very good health. It's been a lovely day, enormous fun. I loved it. Let's hope I can do this in my rather forgotten Portuguese. Bom dia.
Bom dia. Em que eu posso ajudá-las?
Sei, nós estamos os dois gordas. Sim. Para a embaixadriz.
Sim.
Se posso entrar?
Por favor, quero entrar.
Muito obrigada. I think I said we're the two fat ladies for the ambassadress. I might have said we're too fat tops for the ambassador. I hope not.
Jennifer, so do I.
Ah.
Hello.
Good morning, Madam Ambassador.
How are you?
Or put it in a bowl of water and leave a tap dripping on it, which the water board won't like, but the hell with them. They charge us so much money and do so much leaking themselves.
Go back to me next.
I can keep that dirty hand going. Which, of course, is spotlessly clean.
Yes,
for the viewers who worry about such things.
And then you pour in some cream. You can use butter, you can use yoghurt. But in Russia, they would use cream.
Sensible creatures. I've got a very good watering hole round the corner, yes.
Oh,
you'll be surprised.
All right. That's
will
good.
You come with us?
With pleasure, yes.
Take your eyes off the road, ma'am. Robert Square.
Now, you mix it, spoon.
All mixed up.
Now it is ready to drink, madam.